Hey, welcome back, guys, and today I want to talk about a huge, ginormous packing patcher update coming up to Epic 7. Now, this update is, as I said, going to be one of the biggest updates Epic 7 had because of the fact that there is going to be a new PvP mode coming to Epic 7, which I think is the highlight of this update. And I think a lot of you guys will be very excited because it'll make it so that you free-to-play or early game players can actually compete with some older and pay-to-win players as well. Now, we're going to talk about that later, though. Let's look at these new skins and limited units coming out. So, as you can see, we have Pavel and Cerise. We don't know if they're getting skins or if it's just the artwork. You know, sometimes it takes a while for these skins to come out, but the artwork looks amazing for those two units. We also have another character, maybe, or maybe it's Summer Selene. It's hard to really tell, but I kind of predict this will be a new character just because of the fact that they're showing some artwork for this character. Usually, if it's just a skin, they don't really show this too much. And we're also going to see that there is an animation for a different unit coming out in the future, which might signal to us the episode 5 limited unit, or even, you know, somewhere down the line they're going to release this unit, because sometimes they tease these units like a year in advance, as we saw with like Zio and units like that. And you're also going to see potentially a new limited unit. And this looks very, very much like Landy because of her accessories. This might be ML Landy, might be a new ML unit, just might be a new limited unit. So we're not really too sure, but I currently think that it is going to be Landy. It looks very, very much like her. You're going to see that the Epic 7 World Championship schedule is also released as well. So if you guys are interested in watching this, you guys will be actually able to watch this on Twitch and YouTube and whatever other platforms you can watch these Epic 7 streams on. But yeah, this Landy or whatever unit this is, the animations look sick. Very, very excited. Looks like a ice unit, I'd say, because it has to do with water, but hey, it's Epic 7. Sometimes the elements don't correspond with their animations because of the fact that they have to balance the meta, as we saw with like Summertime Hysteria. But looks pretty cool, and I'm pretty excited for these units and skins. Also, guys, we're going to see that there is going to be Summer Luluka most likely coming out. This was teased in the past, and as you guys can see, the artwork is pretty much completely done. And yeah, we don't know how this unit will be until the future when they release her skills. But usually with summer units, they're either at least above average or very good. As we saw with like Summer Break Charlotte, Summertime Hysteria, right? All those new summer units have always been in the meta at some point. So you can see that Summer Luluka is coming up. So it's time to prepare your bookmarks. Make sure you guys start saving those bookmarks because maybe her artifact will be very good as well. And you might want to pull for extra copies. Maybe her imprint will be like speed or critical hit chance. And you want to pull for more copies of her. But at the least, save some bookmarks to have a pity in case you guys have to go for pity on Summer Luluka. Because trust me, just looking at her artwork, guys, like, she looks amazing for sure. You guys are going to want to pull for her and not miss out on her banner. Another thing coming to Epic 7 is going to be some VIP resort service, as you're going to see, for a month. So it's available for 4 weeks. We'll have actually a equipment reset spell, as you can see on the left here. Now, equipment reset is a thing in other gacha games. Basically, what will happen is if you rolled a piece of gear that had good base substats at +0, for example, like arena gear, hell raid gear and stuff like that, or even just regular gear in general, you'll be able to actually reset it and actually put it back to +0, so you have another chance to re-roll it. Now, I'm not sure if this will be limited to one reset per piece of equipment, but in general, if you have pieces that, you know, had very high potential but rolled very badly, this is a good chance to actually get another chance at rolling for this equipment. Now, this might even come to the shop, we're not too sure, because equipment reset is kind of like an entirely new thing. But honestly, I don't think that it'll make it to the shop for a long while because of the fact that, as we saw with modification gem chests, like, those aren't really in the shop either. So I don't really think that'll be available only for people that pay for the game. I think this will be available to free-to-play players very evenly, or at least like somewhat fairly as well. Now, as you guys can see, this is the artwork that we saw in the past, but you can see that there is this unit on the right here. Now, this unit on the right does have that sword that we saw in the animation earlier, which I said is probably a new unit. So it looks pretty cool. Looks like a limited unit coming in the future. It could even be like a Moonlight unit as well, but for the most part, I think this is going to be another limited unit, and she has two big reasons to pull for her, so you guys want to save your bookmarks even after the summer, because we're having some great units coming out, which is very, very nice because of the fact that, you know, Epic 7 has been kind of stale lately with the unit releases, so I'm kind of glad that they're actually releasing more units now. And also, guys, with the every other events, you're going to see that there's going to be places to get equipment with this event, and as you guys can see, this side story or event will probably feature some bosses. As you can see with like the silhouettes here, there's some bosses here. Not really sure if these are bosses that are released in the game, but looks like a worm of some sort with three eyes, obviously, that are red, but pretty cool. Hopefully you guys have your units geared enough to actually do this. I think this is definitely an event you're going to want to come back to the game for if you guys haven't been playing recently, or spend more time on if you've already been playing, because there's so much stuff going on and getting more gear is always good. Now, if these equipment reset scrolls, you can see the animations, or I guess not animations, but the icons here, kind of like gems or like runes or something like that. You can see that. You can actually see that. I think this the left side is going to be for left side equipment. Maybe right side is for accessories. I'm not too sure. It's just like a teaser, and they're just releasing the artwork, so you can see that this is going to be exclusive equipment reset scrolls. Another update coming to Epic 7 that a lot of people have been excited for is going to be the Mysterious Dungeon or Ancient Inheritance. Now, Ancient Inheritance, guys, has been an area of content where a lot of people have been having fun in, where basically you just team up with your guildmates, you communicate through whatever means you can in the in-game chat or even in like Discord and stuff like that, and you strategize to go through the map and get all these rewards. Now, they're actually updating the map and releasing like a second part or second half, which is very nice. The thing is, though, there's like a teaser that it might not be for guilds, it might be for single player as well. As you can see in the bottom here, it is going to say that it was an unexplored dungeon, right? And as you can see, as it changes right now, forbidden to guild. So kind of hard to say, maybe they're just saying that in the past it was forbidden. But if we look actually at the letter at the end of this video, you're gonna see it does say new and ancient inheritance dungeon. So this does make me believe that this is going to be for guilds. So pretty cool areas of content here. You're also going to see that, you know, this is kind of like an overhype thing in my opinion, but people are saying that Epic 7 is available on PC. The thing is, it's not its own dedicated client. It'll still have the same problems as other emulators, because basically Smilegate is just sponsoring a specific emulator, and that is going to be Google Play. So Google Play Games will be the official emulator for Epic 7. I'm not really too concerned about that. I don't know if I'll even change from BlueStacks to Google Play, but maybe I will, because maybe it'll run more smoother, because they'll, you know, figure out better ways to route like the servers. But in short, you know, words, not like a dedicated client, so you will still experience some delays when using an emulator. Also, guys, we have episode 5 coming out finally, which means a new Moon Knight 5-star boss at the end, which we'll be able to pull for, and also just new units and new limited units and more 3-star units. It's going to be in that part of the map which we just saw, but as you guys can see, there's many shadow elves that are going to be in the episode, which if you guys are a fan of elf characters, I guess, which I am completely, then you guys will have a lot of fun with the new characters. Most likely, we're not too sure yet what those characters will look like, but I'm pretty excited as well. As you can see, they're vampires as well. I'm pretty sure Abigail also came from episode 5, so she was just a very early release unit, so it's something to be excited about, and there are going to be just new areas of content you can actually access as well, and this is a big teaser as well. You can see that is probably going to be another unit you can pull for. You can see Abigail on the right here, and on the left, this is going to be a unit you can also pull for. They also teased this unit in the past, and people thought it was going to be like ML like Luna, or maybe like a limited version of Vivian, because of reasons that kind of made it seem that way. Just gonna leave it at that. But as you guys can see, it's most likely going to be a new unit, and these are probably the 3-star units that are coming out. They just look pretty basic compared to the other character designs for the 5-stars. But yeah, new episode coming out, something to be excited for. It's gonna be very fun. There's a lot of units to actually prepare for, and as you can see, it is official. Episode 5, Erasia, is coming out. Conflict among vampires, shadow elves, and humans. So we already have a lot of human characters, so most likely we'll get a few more humans and then a lot of vampires and shadow elves, and 4 chapters will be unlocked at the start of the episode, which is very nice. We're not going to do, you know, one chapter and then another chapter and then another chapter. It's going to be 4 chapters at the start, and most likely one chapter at a time after, so there is some new content to play through. Now, here we go, guys. This is going to be the best part of this update, in my opinion, and that is going to be this draft mode style type of RTA. Basically, it's a card game system, kind of, where you'll be able to choose from 3 units to select into your draft while you're playing in RTA against another opponent. And like I was saying, this will actually make it so that you'll be at an even playing field with older players and even people that spend money on the game, because of the fact that these units already come with their gear, as you can see with their artifacts as well, and as you can see with Mui here on the left, you can also see their exclusive equipment. So you can probably mouse over this in game to see what this does if you're not too sure, so you don't have to memorize everything, and you can see all their stats as well. So if you're looking to take the first turn here, you know, Aya Winter would be a good option because of the fact that she has 279 speed, which is pretty high, and she also has that secret artifact, which will make it so that her CR pushes if the enemy uses a non-attack skill. So this is going to be very fun because, like I said, it evens the playing field completely, and this will make it a lot more tactical. It's not going to be whether you get gear checked, or if you have not been playing the game for that long, you don't have a lot of units, or if you just get outsped because your gear is just bad. You can actually strategize around this, and if you're new to the game and you're just good at these kind of games, you'll be able to rise to the top and surpass players that have even played for like 4 or 5 years since the server's release. I am super excited for this game mode. I will play the crap out of this game mode and most likely primarily play this game mode while farming in the background for RTA, because this is just a lot more fun in my opinion. You don't really get gear checked, and I think a lot of you newer players will find this a lot more fun, and it's a good way to actually get newer players into World's Arena because of the fact that it will actually, you know, introduce you to the game mode, which is pretty fun as well. You're also going to notice that if we go back here, the most frequently used heroes at the bottom, it says that are actually going to be used in ranked battle for RTA will appear. So you're not going to get like crappy units, so it's going to be a lot more balanced than you think. Obviously at the start there'll be some problems because you're going to have to struggle to, you know, find a way to balance this with the stats and stuff, but you're going to see that you can even select units that you don't have, which is a big fun part about this game mode. And yeah, since you're not using the units you have, you can actually see that the equipments and stats will already be predetermined for you, which is going to be a big fun part about this game mode. Very, very excited. This means like you can even beat the last year's Epic 7 World Champion, Phantom, who had insane gear, like to the next degree. I don't even want to talk about how much money he spent apparently, but like his gear was insane on his character, so it kind of made it a little bit unfair if you fought him as a free-to-play player in RTA. I'm not going to say I did, but I definitely did. But now in this game mode, draft mode, you can actually, you know, beat players like that if you just play tactically better. And yeah, last thing, we're going to get, you know, the Epic 7 schedule again for the World Championship. As you can see, this is all the specific qualifiers and main match days. You can see your favorite content creators in there as well. I'm not participating because, honestly, my RTA skills are not good enough, even though I like playing it. But you're also going to see that while we're watching these RTA qualifiers, you're going to see that there is like a new layout or overlay, which is a lot better than the last one, because the last one was very basic, I'd say. And even like the after game results, you can see that there's going to be a lot better ways to see it. So I'm pretty excited for all these changes, very excited for the Epic 7 World Championship as well. And because you'll see that there's an official stage now, so it's going to be super, super fun. And hopefully, you know, you guys get to play in the draft mode and have a lot of fun. And don't feel too bad about being new to the game anymore, because there is a perfectly viable PvP mode that you can play and compete against people, even though you are new and actually have bad gear or lack of units. I think this game mode I'll play so much, guys. I think it's going to be super fun, and I think it'll just be a very, very easy way to make content for me, because, you know, I don't have to rely on changing my gear and stuff like that. Which, by the way, is also a thing. You don't have to, you know, change your gear around to your PvP units from your PvE teams. You just have all that gear on those units from the past. So like, you don't have to actually like switch your hunt gear, your one shot like wyvern team gear, to your PvP units if you want to play PvP, which means you can't farm hunts in the background because all your good gear is on your PvP units now, if you get what I'm saying. So very, very cool to have this draft mode. I'm very excited. So let me know in the comments down below if I missed anything, and also let me know what you guys think about this update. It's a huge update that's coming to the future. It probably won't be in like one patch. It'll probably be like 1, 2, or 3 patches. Let me know actually in the comments what you are most excited for as well, and you know, hopefully you guys will have a lot of fun with this new update. I'm very excited, and I'm super excited for the draft mode, as I've said a million times. And hopefully when it comes out, I can make more content for you guys, and you guys can actually, you know, have a lot of fun. And with draft mode, I actually have a good reason to start streaming now, so I think I'll just stream draft mode primarily. It seems like a super fun area of content, and hopefully it's not too imbalanced at the start. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.